Hello, Tufting Society. It is me, Lady Hale, and on today we're going to do portrait rugs, and I'm going to show you one of the easiest ways to do it using the Adobe Suite. It's a program called Adobe Illustrator. It comes with the CC program, and it includes like Photoshop, Illustrator, the whole pack. Now, as a professional designer, I've been using this now for over 10 years. I started using the Creative Suite back in 2009 when I first learned how to do flyers. That was actually the year my daughter was born. But anyway, so I've been using it for a long time, and I've learned how to be pretty good at it. So we're going to open Illustrator, and I'm going to show you how to separate your colors using Adobe Illustrator. All right. I believe that you can also do the same thing in Silhouette Studio, which is absolutely free as well. Okay. So let's go into Illustrator. So I'm going to go into Illustrator. I'm going to go on new file. Once I go on to new file, I'm going to do 30 inches by 30 inches. Okay. From there, I'm going to go to file. I'm going to press place. Once I press place, I'm going to go ahead and find the picture that I want to use there. There we go. It's in here somewhere. Okay, that's me and Mariah when she's little. Here you go. Perfect. Okay, so I'm going to place this here. I'm going to press shift because I'm going to make this bigger. So first, okay, I'm going to press shift. Oh, so we can make that a little bigger there. And she's so cute. Okay, so now that I have that there, I'm going to click on it. And then you're going to see this bar come up. But you're like, hey, my bar don't come up. If you go to Windows, once you go to Windows, go to Windows, Workspace, and put Essential Classic. And then you'll get all this stuff on there as well, okay? Now, it gives you the option to like, oh, go ahead, edit the picture in Photoshop. You can if you want to darken it, you know, stuff like that. But we don't necessarily need to do that here. So we're going to bring the picture inside of Illustrator. And we're going to trace. It's the button right here that's called Image Trace. Basically, it traces the image. So what you're going to do, I always go down to 6 colors, okay? And then at first, it's going to look ugly. So we don't want it to look ugly. So we're going to go to Window. And we're going to bring in our Image Trace window, okay? So then it won't look ugly. So on your preset is 6 mode color, but on the palette, put full tone, okay? Right now we're working with 100 colors. We don't want to work with 100 colors. We're going to bring that thing all the way down to like 3, okay? All right, now we have that. Now we need to tone it a little bit. So over here, there's a button that's called Advance. So we're going to put that Advance button down. We're going to bring these paths up, okay? So once we start bringing the paths up, okay, you're going to start to see, oh, snaps, okay? This is looking tuftable, okay? It's starting to look a little bit more tuftable, all right? So the higher the image, it's going to make paths. Paths are what goes around your image. Then your own corners, I'm going to make that some more, okay? Right, I'm just gonna keep lifting it up until it's kind of how I want to. Now, if I press Command plus plus plus, all right, I'm able to kind of go in here and look at this, because remember, these are the areas that you're going to be tufting, and see each color, it breaks it down into 3 different colors, not 6, not 7, not 8, but 3 different colors. And if you like, oh snaps, let me just do it where it's 2 colors, you can do 2 accordingly. And nah, I like the 3 better. Okay, I'm just gonna put 3 because that's where I find. Okay, so we have this. So now we gotta play with noise. So if we don't have any noise, it's gonna look like so. But if we sharpen it, so you can do more noise or less noise, okay? The more noise, honestly, it's, let's see, let's put it all the way up here, see what it does. Okay, you're not going to be able to make out your image, but if you bring it down, these sliders are just sliders that you you can, you know, that'll work for you. Okay, so now that we have this there, all right, so when you put this up, obviously you're looking at it to see how tuftable it is. Remember, you're gonna have to test this thing. This looked pretty good to me. Okay, so now you're like, oh my god, that's a bunch of grays, that's a bunch of this, that's a bunch of that. Okay, now we're gonna click on this button right here that says expand. Okay, now once this expand, you see it breaks it down into all these little parts. All right, so now I'm just gonna go and I'm gonna hit this one right here, the direct selection tool, and it let me directly select what I want to keep, what I don't want to keep. So I don't want to keep this, I don't want to keep this, I don't want to keep I don't want to keep that. This gotta, I don't want that. Okay. So, and then even if I only just really wanted the head part, I can take all this stuff out if I want. So now I'm going to get to the hair and I'm going to command plus, 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 well, command, subtract. And then I'm going to go in here, like all this, because this is one, two, three. Okay, these are different color grays. They're three different colors, but I don't need all of this, like around the hair and stuff. So I'm going to just go and like delete some of these grays that I don't need. And if I wanted to turn a gray like another color, you know, you can just select. Oh no, let me go back. That was cute. So we'll leave that there. Okay, so the stuff that I don't want, I'm just, and there's a way you can select by color too. I just forgot how to do it. Okay, so I know I don't need like some of this extra outline. I'm not gonna need that. I mean, if you want to keep it, that's fine. But I know I don't need that. Okay, so a lot of this extra gray, like around the hair part, you know, I know that I'm not about to do all that. Okay, so I just go over here and just really just the part that I know I'm not gonna, oops, nope, don't do that. The part that I know I'm not gonna tuft, I'm just gonna go ahead and just take it out. Real simple. Okay. So I know there's three different types of gray that I'm using. Oh, that looks like kind of going into the thing. So now I'm able to see, hey, okay, I'm able to see exactly what. So now, hold on. All right, I know exactly what the colors that I'm using and all of that. So since I know that, now I'm going to group these together. So I'm just going to go like, what is that? Okay. So now I'm going to group all this together, and I'm going to say group, okay? Now, I'm going to go over here, because I know I want this, like, on a circle. So I'm just going to go in, make a circle. Then I may make this circle, what, like, pink or something. I don't know. I'm done with image trace right now. So now I need to select my my circle, and I need to go over here and select a color to fill it with. Maybe we'll do like a pink or something, right? So now I'm gonna take a circle, I'm gonna take the circle, and then I'm gonna arrange. So I'm gonna bring it, I'm gonna send backwards. Okay, since I know that I'm gonna send my image backwards. What the heck? No, I want my image like this, like so. Okay. Now I need to combine my images. And so now I need to go to my Pathfinder, which I need to find. Okay. And then I'm just going to merge these, shapes. God dang it, that's what I need to do. Shape. Oh, Lord, I didn't mean to do it like that, though. Is it like that? Y'all forgot how to put the dang thing in there. So, I know I need to do Pathfinder. So I need to go window, Pathfinder, then, oh, this is what I need to do too, so, oops me. So let's ungroup, oops, not like that. Here. And what did I say? Select. Oh, is it this make clipping path? Oh, okay. So I put this in here. Select both. Then I say make clipping mask. Yes. Oops. No. This one. Yeah, but I want to keep my colors. You know, I'm going to save my image and I'll bring it into Photoshop and do it because I don't know how to do it like this. You can do it in Illustrator, but we're not going to do that today. So I'm going to take my image. Sorry, guys. So I'm going to take my image. I'm going to save my image as. I'm going to save it as. Ready. Okay. I'm going to save all my computers. And then Adobe. I'm going to save it as a SVG. Tufting export. Okay. Alright. So now I'm going to save this SVG. So now that I saved it. Okay, I'm going to quit Illustrator. And then I'm going to open up Photoshop. So hopefully, while this is recording, it'll let me do it. Okay. All right, so the Photoshop is opening. So just like this, I'm going to create a 30 by 30. Okay. Now, I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to do the two just like I just did in, did there. But now I can turn this into whatever color I want. So I'm going to go to fill, maybe like a pretty pink fuchsia. Okay, then I'm gonna come over here. I'm gonna get my photo that I had over there. Hopefully it comes in here right, which it does. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. All right. So now I know that I can put this over here accordingly. Now when I do that, I can create a clipping mask. Okay. And that's gonna put this inside of here. So I know that this can go there. Right. And then once I have, I think I'm gonna make that a little darker. So it's gonna make that color a little darker, like a almost like a purple. Oh, that's pretty. But I'm gonna change my mind. So I'm gonna do it the same color. I'm gonna press this. And then I'm just gonna go and select the color that's in there and say like so. So it'll be that. And then I'm going to go to my typing tool. And I didn't like where they put that at. Obviously. I'm just gonna turn it black so I can see it right now. Oh, it's inside the clipping mask, that's why I can't see it. And these would be cute. I'm just gonna put a baby. Okay. I'm just gonna come over here and adjust the the stuff. Okay. Maybe I want to find like a really nice font. I like to use fonts that are a little easier for tufting, but you can use whatever font you want. Okay, don't let that be. Don't let me being lazy. Okay, and I'm just adjusting the thing. And then I'm just going to go over here, go to blending options, and I'm going to put a stroke around, I'm going to use the color that I'm, one of the colors that I'm tufting with, and then, oops, there we go. Go to blending options, and then we can put okay. And then whatever you want that, you know, this the outline to be, because you can do an outline or you can not do an outline, your choice, right? But you can pick whichever color you think might best go with. There you go. Yeah, the darker color. I think that contrasts better. You can make this as big as small. You know, I would have it like maybe something like this. And then I'm going to like put it. Then I'm going to just come in here and, you know, or I might put her name. Okay. You know, some people like, you know, Mariah's sit spot, or, you know, whatever you wanted to say. So if I wanted to above her. Then I could put, you know, make it big, make the font bigger. And then, you know, maybe this is something where she wants to sit, or I don't know. You can just, you know, turn it whatever way that you want. Maria. Who?
Who is that? Was that Mariah?
Yeah. Or if you want to just on here. And then maybe you want to just put it really big. You can do that too. So you just bring it down below her. Command T, hold your shift. And you can actually do it like this. Then you can take just a little smaller so you can actually read it. You can do it where it cuts off. And then you take the baby like so. Or you can do the words. Okay. This is why I get paid the big bucks, y'all. You know, and put it. Just remember you're tufting this, so you need to consider your, you know, your you tufting or whatever when you do this. Or you can put the name where you can actually see the name, because that would be smart. M-I-R-L-I-R. Okay, and then when you come over here with so, I will put blending options. I will do a stroke. I will make the stroke just a little smaller. But enough to go around here like so. So that gives you some wiggle room to play with there. And you can use the eraser tool. Just say okay. And then I will come in and obviously erase that. That little extra dot. But when you're tufting, you know where to make your thing at, right? So she still has the cute little thing like so. And then obviously if you want the name to be seen a little more, you can do that. And then on the outline of the eclipse, I would go like so, blending options. I will put that same stroke around there. Okay. And boom, okay, you have a perfectly ready to tuft rug, you know, rug, okay. And then, and as you see, now I'm going to show you how you set this up to do your colors. So now I'm going to put all of this together. Okay. I'm going to put all of this together and I'm going to put it in one folder and I'm going to label this carpet. Now, we need to go through our carpet. Oops. Okay. Now we need to go through our carpet, and we need to get the colors. So we're going to do a new folder, okay, and we're going to call this folder colors. So then you know what colors you're going to need when, well, actually, let's do a new thing. So let's just label this. Let's save this. Okay. Because now you're like, how do I know what colors that I need? Okay. So we're going to enable this. Mariah's portrait. Okay. Now, because we're going to break this thing down by colors. And now in this part, let's see how much time we own. Okay, good. Okay, I try not to be on for more than an hour. So we're good. So now we're going to go in Photoshop. And I'm just going to print this new. Help me. I'm going to say new. Okay. Once I go into new, I'm just going to put this on a normal, 8.5 by 11. And I'm going to say create. Okay. So now that I have this color, I'm going to go through and then I'm going to make me some boxes. So each box, I'm just going to go, because I know it's a bunch of different ones. Create your box. Then you're just going to go Command J, 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 J. Okay. Once you press Command J, that does nothing but just, make you an extra box. So we're going to pull these boxes till we can't pull them no more. Okay. All right. So I'm just going to click on this. Command J. Command J. Okay. And then what we're going to do first, I'm going to click on my first box. And now we're going to break this thing down by colors. Okay. So first we're going to start with our blacks and grays, right? So from there, I'm just going to go over here and I'm just going to click on the color. All right. So I know this is this. I'm going to say copy. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to go over here to my box. I'm going to do this. Click here. Paste. Okay. So I know that's that color. Now I need to come over here and pick. I got my black. So now I need to pick this other color. This gray. Okay. Same thing. Copy. I'm going to come over here. Like so. Fill this mug in with, bam, this color here. So I know that this is like, I like to write my own notes. Okay. So when I'm at the store and I'm picking out my colors. What the heck? Why does it this? Oh, because it's white. Okay. So when I'm at the store, I know what dang color it is. So I'm going to be like black. I know this is black, right? And I need to put it where I can see that it's black, obviously. Oh, this is why. And I just need it like so. Is a black. Then when I hit this copy and paste button here, Command J, I know this is a dark gray. So I'm gonna say DK gray. Okay, because you got black and I have a dark gray. Okay, I know that color. Then I'm going to go to the next color over here. which is I have black, dark gray, gray, and light gray. So you got dark black. Then let's say yeah, we got dark black, dark gray, gray. Let's copy. Come back over here. Then we have this gray color. So you got dark, these are different grays. I think, shit, let me look at it, Jack, because I can't see. Did I already? No, this one is lighter. Dark gray. Yeah, now that one looks lighter to me. We got dark gray, gray. We had this gray right here, so we're gonna go light gray. Okay. I'm just gonna fill this in accordingly. Thanks. That ain't right. I think I done did the color twice. Okay, let's do our colors. We got black, dark gray, which is this color gray here. So let's go here. So just copy. Let's make sure we got our colors right. Copy. There we go. That's black, dark gray. Then we have this gray, which is black, dark gray, then gray and light gray. So let's select this gray. Okay. Paste. Okay. Now we're ready for the light gray. So we come over here and then gray, I'm gonna say okay. We come here. Okay, and then we're gonna say this is the lighter gray. So Command J. Lighter. Okay. So now we're gonna take these ones. We got, you know, different colors. And then we're gonna make Command J. Okay. And then now let's select the skin color. So we're gonna go over here. Alright. I'm going to start with, Jesus, it's a lot of gray. I'm going to start with the skin tones. So first, we have this brown. So say okay. So we got over here. We got this brown. Then we come over. This is a lighter shade of brown. So it's like let's see, we gotta move up to see that color. See, these are different. These are all different shades of brown. So you got this color brown, which would come over here, and we'll just label it accordingly. We got that color brown. Then we have this. Got that. This color brown, and we're just gonna come over here, and each time we're just gonna label our browns. Okay, so y'all see those different color browns? 1, 2, 3, and then you got 1, 2, 3, 4. That color brown. And just so y'all can see that those are all different color browns, okay? So we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have this color brown. And then we're going to just press Command-J, bring this over again. Okay. And then we're just going to say, like so, 91651. Yep. So Command J. And we're just gonna come over here. Here, select Command. Okay, and as you see, we have a whole variety of skin tone there. think. And then this color was what? And then some of the skin tones, you could, if you like, I can't find all of this, you can obviously go into the image and fix it. You can take out some colors because you're like, okay, hold on, there's a little bit too many colors there. And you can fill them in to like match, because right now we got like a lot of browns. And that's just right here, right? So now we're going to go in and adjust this because it's too many browns. Okay. So when you go in and adjust your colors, you need to look at it. Because I'm trying to keep it down to a certain amount of browns. Like, personally, this brown and this brown can actually be the same color. So what I would go in and do is that I will select this brown, select my paint bucket, and select this brown, and then I'll just come in over here and I'll just fill it in the same color. Okay. So now when I fill that in the same color, I might come over here, though these are different color brown. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Command Z. Okay, so now right here is broken down. And we got four different colors here. Oops. Because if I did that would make it look crazy. Okay. So the goal is to keep, you see how we had this into four different colors. So the goal would be to keep these into four different colors. So you got like, you want your brown. These are the three colors you want. So come on. So when I'm looking at this, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have 7 different browns right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, that's 7 different browns. So, since I know I got 7 different browns, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I need to keep those browns, the darker ones, kind of close, but I know that they are different colors. So this is why when I tell you break it down in colors in Illustrator, because you still gonna need a lot of stuff for this. So we're gonna come down here, let's break this down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so we got one, which is this chocolate brown. So this chocolate brown, then next to chocolate brown. So we have, I'm just going to say dark chocolate. I got dark chocolate. Then I got DKCH. I know what that means. Dark CH. Okay, so I have dark chocolate. Then we have Command J, light. So this is light. The dark chocolate. Okay. So you got dark chocolate, light dark chocolate, chocolate, brown, you know, damn near tan. So you have the different different colors of the chocolate. All right. So and there are 7 different ones, and I'll show y'all what I mean. Okay, I'm gonna show you the difference in chocolates. So this is one, well, this was like our second word we ever did. So it's ugly. So don't y'all judge this ugly rug. But as you see, the chocolates come in different color. So you have dark chocolate, lighter chocolate. I call it the cocoa colors. Right? So I know it's the cocoa colors. So I'm gonna write cocoa colors. On my thing. Okay. So let's save some time. Okay. I told y'all I was going. So I'm put cocoa colors. Which I like to call the 7 chocolates. Because I'm not going to write down each and every name of the colors. Because I don't know them by heart. But all I know is it's the cocoa colors. It's the 7. And I'm going to put 7. So when I'm shopping, I'm going to do 7 cocoa colors. Okay. Now, Command J. And then there was some other colors here. So now we're pretty much done with our face colors, because we know it's the selection. I know I need white, so white, that's like duh, know that. And then I need like a little, what is this, pink. So let's kind of get this color here. The rest of the colors is just kind of remembering the pink. So I'm say that. See, that's about the same color. Those are both, well, one is rose and one of them is pink. So we got pink. So I know I need the pink color. So now I need this pink. I need light pink. So this light pink. This color is. Oh, I don't even got my thing on the stupid thing. Sorry, guys. So I'm gonna need this other pretty maroon looking color. Same maroon. And what is that background color that I use? I don't know what color this is, but it's pretty. It's like one of those pinks, one of those dark pinks. Oh, that's kind of like that first color. So this is the, so that's the, so I'm going to put this down to where it says background. There we go. So these colors are more fill-in colors. So let's go ahead and get those. So pretty little burnt orange color. Okay. And then it's like these random greens and grays. So I'm gonna go here and whatever this color is, that color. I'm just gonna select a color, then this green color. Then it's a little, another little light green color. I got a blue and a light blue. It's like a three different blues. Blue. Then it's a blue. Okay. And then it's this other blue. Yeah, this is gonna be a project. Okay, this, like, in my head, I just got tired of counting colors. Man, listen. Do. And I think it's on my collar, Jesus. Okay, we already know white and gray. So we have some gray. We have some like some titaniums and stuff like that. So in my notes when I'm at the store, then I'm going to write white gray. Off-white and titanium. Okay. So then I know, hey, girl, make sure you get some white, titanium, this right there. Okay, so we've hung out this morning, okay, and if you got any questions, you can go ahead and ask them, okay? So that's how I go through, and I'm just gonna save this as a copy of a colors for portrait. Okay, because that's gonna be so pretty. I think I'm gonna have to do it big. I'm gonna have to do this big. It's gonna be so pretty. I'm not saving this as a PDF. I'm trying to save this as a PDF. Save to my computer. Okay. Okay. Now I got it backwards and it's ready to tilt. So. Save as, save a copy. Spotify's portrait rug. PNG. And I had to put it on my other file thing, but I'll save it to there later. So now this image is ready to tuft. So we got our portrait rug ready to tuft and saved it. And we got our palettes. Okay. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed this training that we did today. If you have not already, depending on where you're watching this from, you can join us at the Tufting Society, where we have more free clinics and workshops just like this, showing you how to make rugs, etc. Thank you so much for joining us. God bless you all, and happy tufting. If you want to visit our site, rugsbyme.com, you're more than welcome. You're more than welcome to visit that. All right, have a blessed day.